Hey guys, Loop the Great here again with another episode of The Forest Creative. And I have done some mob building, of course. And you guys are hilarious. I put something in there in the last episode just to see what would happen, and I should have known the silliness of the internet. On the poll, I put, should I do more shops? And you can kind of see something over there. Or should I start the castle already? And for fun, I just put in potato. And guess what won, guys? Potato. By 53%. Followed up by start the castle already. And as you can see, there's something going on over there. Which we will definitely look at. But first, I put together... Because I can't build a potato in this. I guess these are, they look like potatoes, maybe. Yeah. The rocks. Rock potato. But I put together a little something for my love, and I believe your love, of potatoes. Alright, guys. How about that? I love potatoes! Oh, yeah! And I have started work on the castle. Look at this platform! Good loud! And this is just the first floor. Of course, as the subsequent floors go up, they will go further back because they will just keep going with the side of this mountain, so they'll go further back. And I'm gonna, like, tier it. I've got a lot of different ideas in plans for this castle. And just getting this done, this was not a super easy feat. And my frames are kind of low right now. I'm building so much in this game that it's actually affecting my frames. But, of course, we have the dungeon. Ah! And the reason I had to do this in a certain way, which took a while, because I wanted a straight, perfectly straight... Well, straight, perfectly level wall going across the front. I did end up covering it up a little bit. See this? I covered it up because I put stuff in front of it anyway, because I wanted this epic entrance, which is that. But this, making a perfectly level wall that contours to a slope this severe, was not easy. And you can kind of see a little bit poking through right here. I had to do multiple levels of floor, and then just keep on building up and going across another layer of floor, go across the next layer, another layer of floor, go across the next layer. And finally, after all that, I ended up with a nice, beautiful, it's got one row on top just to kind of blend it together, but this wall, look at this, and it's on extremely uneven surface underneath. The wall even goes down farther than this little walk that I've made. It goes all the way to the bottom. This right here, this floor was the first floor I placed, and it's kind of just on the surface of the water. And then from there, I went all the way around, and it just... I'm really, really proud of the way it came out. That wall for the basement slash dungeon slash base of this soon-to-be castle looks amazing. And of course, as you can see, I'm walking on a little bit of a bridge here. I wanted another place to cross the river. Well, the little lake, I guess, up here. Other than this one, which I do love, of course. But I figured it'd be nice to surround it. So we've also got a path here. Starts here, goes around, goes under the walk that you take to go up to. And this isn't beautiful, but it's whatever. And of course, I covered the whole front of it with stone, and to do that perfectly straight and even, I did another little platform that's just on the surface of the water. So So it kind of looks like a barge. It looks like it's floating. But that allowed me to do nice flat, straight, beautiful, perpendicular, what all the words that mean true and looking good. All those words. And of course, this would be the entrance. Ba-bam and ba-bam. And imagine just a giant castle right here. And the first thing I want to do for this giant castle is the biggest fireplace I have ever done. I'm so excited to do this. So excited to see how it happens. Because I'm going to build it around, not a small fire pit, not a medium-sized fire pit, not even one of these. I'm going to make a bonfire fireplace. And it's going to be so awesome! And it's going to be like right in the middle of the building, which is going to be probably about here. Make it wider than it is long. Let's see. And I'm building the fireplace first. Well, that's too far back. Crap. Oh, hello, Magic Log. I'm building a fireplace first because I want everything to focus around it. I don't have to worry about the stone snapping to weird things, you know? I want it to be awesome. Let me put this down. So my whole plan for this, if the first level at least, this giant fireplace in the middle going all the way up through, two, like, curved somewhat. Where are you going? Shouldn't be rolling. It should be a level floor. Stop it. Oh, it's like settling right there. All right, fine. Giant room, of course. The first floor, giant room. There'll be more rooms and more floors on this side because it goes a little farther this way. But I'm going to see if I can make it pretty much from this space, from this spot. Even, however many logs that way is the same that way for the main building. So it looks like a square, rectangle, slate type building. So it's equal. So the door is in the middle of the building, basically. And what I'm going to do for the doors is I have to do the double doors. So I have to do the fence door, the defensive wall doors. So I'm going to work that out and have something up and over it. So it's going to look similar to the way that I have these doors surrounded here. With something over it, with stones all around it. But of course, I'm going to do it with walls instead of platforms and stuff. But yeah, it's going to look similar to this, but it's going to be stone all the way up and around it, which should look amazing. It's going to be a nice surround. And of course, double doors. Where's the vent? There it is. Double doors like that in the front. I want to see if I can get them lined up perfectly, because this, I've always been a little off of this, because it's not, it's like 3 points at the top instead of 2, so it doesn't split right at the top point, so it's weird. I don't know if I'm not sure if that's something I can really tune in that well, but I gotta try it. So that is definitely gonna be the next episode. But to finish off this one, we'll see if we can do a little bit of a speed build and get at least the start of this fireplace done. Let's do it! Alright, there it is, guys. Good lord, that is a big fireplace. And as you can see in the speed 'em up that I did, I made it large enough that I can put another one of these in here. Which is really, really a good idea. Because, you know, the other ones, once they once the fires break, you can't put the large enough size fire in there again. But, oh my god, this thing is huge. It's not, I'm noticing now it's a little thicker on one side than the other, but I'm not too worried about it. I love it, and I think it looks amazing. And that chimney is going to continue up throughout the entire place. So as I actually build levels, you saw that I had to do some quick scaffolding, some stairs that I then broke. But man, the mantles on this thing, and oh, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. And it doubles as the back wall here. I'm just going to finish this off to actually make this a room. Hopefully, I can make this wall long enough. I'll actually have a door in it. Maybe I'll have to do one of these. On an angle? Oh, I like auto finishes there. Yes, into the wall. I love that. Actually, the door should be on the other side because that's where the stairs go down. But let's build this. And another one of those. So you're starting to see what's going on with some rooms, sort of. So this is going to be one very large room. And I'm going to have stairs coming down probably to about here. And then going up and then across. Going around the fireplace on both sides. Up and then across. And the first main room here is going to be 3 high. And then from then on, we'll go, we'll narrow it down a little bit. Maybe I'll do 2 high and then in a little bit. And try to do like the classic Mario King Koopa castle. That's what I want to do. That's what I kind of want it to look like. All right, let's do the same thing over here. Finish this off. Did that autocomplete into the wall? That would be really nice if it did, so it looked nice and clean. I guess that's close enough. All right, door, please. Yes. Same thing here. Trying to make them phase into the wall, not always as easy as it looks. Yeah, not so much. I'll do what I can there. But this will be the door, and then you can go into the dungeon here, obviously. Okay. I might do a little room back here, too. If I put a roof across this, like lower than... Oh, no. I want the whole thing to go... I will put a roof all the way across this. So you'll be able to go behind it on the third floor also. But on the first floor, it's just going to be open all the way to the top. Very open, very awesome. All right. Now let's see if we can do the gate. Wait, is the a defensive wall there? Now, this is going to take a little bit of testing. If I start it here... And go to here. Would that be, like, way too easy? Alright. Yes. Yeah. Not even. Dang it. Troy, I want it to be even. And I need it to open in, obviously. So let's go a little farther. I actually want it to start back here. It automatically snaps to that because that's the edge of the platform. Okay, fine. Oh, that added one more log. Oh! That didn't look right at all. Alright, I'm gonna get this figured out. I'll be right back to you. No matter what I do, it's never perfectly centered. I guess that's the way it's gonna be. Now let me see here. I don't remember if, oh wait, open out? Open. That means open in, right? Yes! Okay, there isn't a lot of room in the courtyard here. You're dumped right into the fireplace. Because I couldn't have those... Yeah. Actually, I should destroy some of these rocks and start it farther back. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Sucks, but I gotta do it. I gotta make it right. Alright, I hate that I had to do that, but I need to make this. I need to give myself a little more room. If I start from here, go exactly to here. Let's see. Okay. Oh, off center! Oh my god, that's terrible. Okay. Nope. So much nope. I need to make it smaller. Okay, so how about from here? Huh? Still not perfect, but it'll give me more room. Alright, open in. That is gorgeous. Now I just gotta replace the stones back up to it. And it doesn't open perfectly, but I'm happy with that. I am very, very happy with that. That is an entrance to a castle. And I'm going to go up and around it. I'm actually going to see if I can surround it with stone. And then the rest will be wood, of course. I can't do the entire castle out of stone, although I'd love to. Because you can't really put windows in it. And it would just be so hard to build that way. But, we're going to make it happen. I might actually just use wood here. I had these stone walls because I was originally thinking I would do, like, another path that goes all the way from here, all the way across, and then you'd have the gate here, and then open it up into the room. But, just for the fact that I made this fireplace so big, it doesn't give me the room to do that. So... I think I'm actually going to destroy all these upper layer and start the wood walls here. But around this, we'll do a small column of stone up and across the front and then back down. So it looks like a good surround. It'll be awesome! So awesome! But for now, that is the end of this one. And I have to... It's not quite night yet, but this thing will look amazing at night, of course. And I can build another one of these and put it in there if I need to. But that is a fireplace. Look at my hand. Very nice hand. Alright, good. That is a fireplace. That is gorgeous. Put this away. If we go to this, you can barely see it in the picture. Ha ha! But oh my god. I love it. You! You need to just go over here. I don't care about you. Go down there. Yes. Wait, what if I look like through here? Oh, I love it. This castle is going to be amazing. And thank you, everybody, for voting, especially for the people who voted potato. I love the absurdity that is the internet sometimes. Who would vote for potato? Who would do that? I would. I actually voted potato. Ah, I did it. And you got some potato. And you got the castle, because that was the runner-up. I'm going to finish this up. I'm going to do a lot more on this, and a lot more work on this, and I will get back to you guys in the next episode, and we'll see how this castle has grown. It's so pretty. It's so pretty. It's going to be so pretty. Not wait, if I go here. Now it's more centered. Yeah. But I'm not centered on the platform. Gah! You can't make things perfect in this game, but in that not perfectness, in that rusticness, I guess, is definitely some beauty. It doesn't have to be perfect. It can't be perfectly straight every time. But it still looks amazeballs. Thank you so much, guys. If you like what you saw, make sure to hit that like button. If you really like what you saw, make sure to subscribe! And of course, I've got a building over there that I kind of did a little modification to also. I'll talk about that in the next one. I know I conceded and I'll do the castle this episode, but I also did some more shop work. Because I can't help it, I did both. So, shh, don't tell anyone I did both. But that'll be for the next one. This is castle and potato, of course. Thank you so much, guys. Have a good day. Have a good night. I love you and goodbye. Hey, let me end my castle. Oh, now it's getting night. Look at this thing. Back up right up to it. Oh, that is a fireplace right there. Check that out. Yeah. Thank you for watching my video, guys. If you like what you saw, definitely hit that logo over there. The L. That's to subscribe to my channel to get more of these videos daily. Awesome stuff, whether it's Scrap Mechanics or Forest or anything else I'm playing. If you want to check out my vlog, punch me in the face. Go ahead, hit my face. That brings you over to my vlog channel. That's getting dark and bright. And of course, more videos of mine on the right. Check them out, guys. Thank you so much. Goodbye.